Hi, welcome to my channel, Right to Learn. Now we are going to discuss part 2 of link server. If you have not watched part 1 of link server, I am giving you link in the description. Please do watch part 1 of link server. So now continue with part 2. So in this part 2, I am going to discuss how to establish a link server between two different RDBMS products. So I have two RDBMS products installed in my machine. One is SQL Server and another one is PostgreSQL. So using SQL Server, I am going to access the database person and particularly the table electronics from PostgreSQL. So I'll show you how do we do that. So before we go into that lab, we need to install ODBC drivers for PostgreSQL. ODBC is Open Database Connectivity Drivers. So I will give you a link in the description. Using that link, you can download the PostgreSQL ODBC drivers. So just open your browser. So this is the link. So you need to download the latest one. So in my case, I have 64-bit Windows OS running. So I'm going to download the 64-bit one. So this is the latest one. So just click on it. The file gets downloaded. So it gets downloaded in the zip format. You need to extract it. Since I have already installed this file, I'm skipping the installation procedure. If you face any difficulties while installing this ODBC drivers, please do comment in the below. So after installing, just go to Windows Administrative Tools. If you are running Windows 10 in your machine, just go to search bar and type Administrative Tools. Otherwise, if you are running Windows 7, you just go to Control Panel, System and Security, and then Administrative Tools. And then go to ODBC data sources 64-bit. Okay, a dialog box opens. Click on System DSN and click Add. Search for PostgreSQL Unicode 64. Since I have downloaded 64-bit ODBC drivers, click Finish. So you need to enter few details. Which these details belongs to PostgreSQL server. So data source, you can enter anything. In my case, I'm entering XYZ. Okay, XYZ, and the database, server name, username, password. You need to get it from the Postgres. I'll show you how to get these details from Postgres. Let me open my PostgreSQL server. So this is the Postgres admin. So I have two servers here, BaloSQL and PostgreSQL. In this case, I'm taking BaloSQL. So right click, properties, see here this is the name, and go to connection. So this is the localhost. So in the server name of administrative tools, in here you need to write the localhost. So generally it will be an IP address in production server. So this is the localhost in my case. And it is running on port number 5432 and username is 7up, and you need to enter the password which is associated with 7up. So that's it here in these details. So go back to your administrative tools. So description, you can enter your remarks, anything. And database, I have a database person, and the server is localhost. And port number is 5432, username is 7up, and the username is case sensitive. We need to enter the uppercase letters if you have created as uppercase letters in your Postgres. And password is the same password which you have given at the time of creation of the user, 7up. So just click on test. If the connection is successful, then you are done. So the connection is successful in my case. So the setup has been done. Now you need to go back to your SQL server and create a link server. So since the all details has been entered, click save. Before you click save, remember the data source name which you have given. See, in my case I have given XYZ and user is 7up and password is the same password. So in SQL server, this username and password becomes the remote username and remote password. Okay, click save. Okay, now go back to your SQL server. So this is my SQL server instance. Click here, click security, sorry, server objects, link server, right click, new link server. Here you need to enter link server name. So this link server name, this would be the server name in my pgAdmin. I'll show you in pgAdmin. So in this pgAdmin, this is the link server name. So Balu SQL is the link server name. So go back to SQL. So link server name is Balu SQL, and server type you need to select other data source because it is not a SQL server. We are choosing other RDBMS products. And in provider drop down, you need to search for Microsoft OLEDB provider for ODBC drivers. Select this. Product name, you can give anything, Postgres. And data source, do you remember I have told you the data source you can give anything while setting the administrative tools. So what I have given X, Y, Z. Provider string location catalog, you can ignore it. And go to security. Here, click this. Be made using this security context. If you click this, this will get enabled. So remote login is 7up. Password. Okay. And next, server options. This is an important step. RPC and RPC out should be set true. So RPC is remote procedure call. This should be set true. So both case you need to set as true. And click OK. So the link server has been created. See, Balu SQL. So right click, test the connection. So the connection is successful in SQL. So let us check whether we can access the table electronics from Postgres. Let me show you what are the contents present in table electronics in Postgres. So this is the Postgres. So click here. I have database person. Right click, query tool. Select star from parser. Run the query. Select star from parser. So let me check what are the requirements. So person is the database name. In that person, I'm going to access the table. So the table here is electronics. So I'm just executing this query. So this table electronics contains two rows, Samsung and Apple. So this is the table serial number and make. So this row, Samsung and Apple, has to be appear in SQL server because we have established a link server. So go back to SQL server, new query, select star from, this is the server name, Balu SQL dot, next database name, database is person dot, and next schema name. So this should be in public, because this is the other RDBMS product. So public enclose this public in square brackets and then table name. So this is the format. Click on execute. See, I can able to view the table of electronics from SQL Server. So these are the table which are contained in Postgres. Let me show you. I will insert one row. So here there are only two rows. Now I am going to insert one more row in the same table. Insert into electronics values 3 comma Nokia. Run the query. So query returned successfully. So now see whether you will be able to see 3 rows or not here. So here I can able to see 3 rows. Now go back to your SQL and execute the query. See, here also I can able to view the third row which is just inserted in Postgres. Okay, so you can also insert a data into electronics table which is present in Postgres. So let me show you that also. Insert into this values 4 So I'm inserting the fourth row. Okay, let me check whether it get successful or not. Wow, so the another row also got inserted. So I can insert from here also, no need to go to Postgres. So execute. See, this one got inserted, HTC got inserted, and you can view the data in Postgres also. Go back to Postgres, select star from electronics, run the query. You can view the fourth row also. So you can insert the data from here also and from SQL also, but that purely depends on the permissions of the user, what permission the user has given. Okay, if you have any queries in establishing a link server between these two RDBMS products, please do comment below. I'll reply your queries if possible. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe for more videos.